The construction industry contributes over $430 billion to the U.S. economy every year, but at a terrible human cost.
Construction's full of bravado, right? You know, we're big boys with big toys, and we can build anything. The tougher it is, the more we like it. We're not scared of anything.
Industrial accidents claim the lives of 13 workers every day, with 700 fatalities a year in the construction industry, and millions more people who are injured on the job. The four leading industrial killers are falls, electrocution, being struck by an object, or being crushed. And with 11 deaths per 100,000 workers, the U.S. mortality rate is among the highest in the developed world.
As a person, I cannot accept this idea in our industry that things happen, that people get hurt, and that's just the way it is.
To change the dynamic of safety in the workplace, it takes leadership at every level.
To construction workers and their families, the human costs are heartbreaking and the economic costs are staggering. In order to battle the flood of personal tragedy and squandered productivity in the U.S. construction industry, in 2009, senior leaders of 15 companies banded together to establish the Incident and Injury-Free CEO Forum.
It's intended to let CEOs work together to improve safety on everyone's job, not just their own, but in the whole industry.
To dramatically alter the number of people who are injured in our industry and our tolerance for those kinds of injuries by driving that caring into our entire industry.
International construction giant Skanska is a longtime IIF supporter. CEO Mike McNally says the forum takes the safety conversation to a new level by reaching out to all stakeholders. The forum brings forward the leadership necessary to shift construction from business as usual to an incident and injury-free mindset. It's a huge challenge, but it has to be addressed.
If we're going to change our companies and make the world safe for our people, we've got to make the industry safe as well.
Although these construction companies are often competitors bidding on the same projects, they share a common value for worker safety.
A very interesting group. We're fierce competitors, yet we really rally around the whole concept and idea of safety and about people.
No one can be a fierce competitor when it comes to keeping people safe. It's just wrong.
Twice a year, members come together for meetings facilitated by JMJ Associates, pioneers in creating incident and injury free, or IIF, workplaces and projects.
JMJ really was able to take our leadership team and change that paradigm. And then we work with them to work down through the organizations to get right down to our superintendents and our project managers and on-site people.
Here at Gilbane, we have a safety culture. I mean, that is the culture. So that message comes through if you're new to the company or if you've been with the company a long time. So that gets transmitted out into the field to the employees and to the guys out there working. Gilbane cares, and we want everybody to go home tonight.
You guys okay with, with today, where we're at?
Building an incident and injury-free workplace of genuine care and concern takes the commitment of senior leadership over time. Time to overcome unsafe practices and to unlearn attitudes that lead to accidents.
The biggest thing is for inclusion. Get everybody to understand the plan, sharing the plan, understanding the hazards of doing the work. Be able to create a safe environment for our people, our subcontractors, and everybody else around us.
The biggest impact for me was it changed my perspective of safety from a perspective of compliance to a perspective of caring for each individual and making sure we're doing the right thing for that person.
IIF also takes the commitment of line supervisors who genuinely care for the health and well-being of their employees.
We take a personal approach towards safety on a job site. I like to give personal stories, personal experiences, and talk to people, get to know them, not just yell at them and tell them they have to do stuff, but explain why.
When you have a lot of people working together to care for one another, it creates an atmosphere of a family type.
And the other thing we find with our subcontractors and our folks that works for us is that when we care about them, we get that back. And that pays off in a whole series of ways, productivity and a whole bunch of ways on our projects. IIF has really been received by the company in the aspect of caring for people and respect for people in a way that a lot of people told me you're not going to get that in New York City, but you do.
IIF changes the company culture.
What this has done is it helps to rally around our culture and behavior and how we want all of our people to behave. And it is just phenomenal. I just can't say any more positives about it.
If your jobs are cleaner and they're neater and they're more organized and there's more communication and it's a safer place to work, then the trades respond very well. You got to get to the point where I honestly care about you as a person, and then the other stuff follows.
Leaders who belong to the forum say the benefits of collaboration pay huge dividends.
It's just truly amazing. We share ideas, we share education, we share training, to really help the industry.
The way it's impacted me as a leader, it has allowed our management team to have a common language, a common platform, a common mission in our business, so that we can both focus on our safety culture, but also in our total culture caring for the company.
I think I've always been a caring person, and I'm always looking out for people, but this has really brought out the best in me.
That for us, having our people go home safe each and every day is our most fundamental responsibilities personally.
And I can feel good about what we're doing, because I know we're at the leading edge of what's going on in safety, probably in the world. I can look in the mirror every morning and shave.
Ultimately, the goal of the CEO Forum is to change the entire construction industry by proving what's possible when management and workers align around a common goal for workplace safety.
It's a change of beliefs that incidents can be prevented. And until you really believe something, it can't happen. You have to persevere, and there can be no failure. And it's not an option. And we're going to get there. And our goal is world-class safety and to have zero incidents.
Incident and injury-free is a journey. Every milepost along that journey is very hard-earned. But the fact that men and women can go home every night to their families makes every one of those efforts worthwhile.
The rewarding thing is we don't get patted on the back by anybody, because people don't get hurt. And when people don't get hurt, they don't know to go out of their way to thank someone for something that didn't happen. Yet I think we all know, and personally I know, we're doing the right thing.